As we all know, the Vatican hierarchy is made up of many ranks, just as was the original military ranks of pagan Rome. And one of the ranks that just about everyone alive knows about is, in fact, the office of cardinal, which is second only to the pope, a vice president of the pope, if you will. In fact, it was stated back in May, and, well, actually, many times before, but I found this article from back in May, where it says, many things changed on March 13, 2013, the day Cardinal Jorge Mario Bergoglio of Argentina was elected as Pope Francis. Perhaps nothing mutated as dramatically as the career of Honduran Cardinal Oscar Rodriguez Maradiaga, a leading progressive voice in Catholicism. Today, he comes off as virtually a vice pope, the coordinator of Francis's all-important Council of Cardinal Advisors, and his most visible and outspoken interpreter. And yes, this vice pope is just as evil as the pope. I mean, check this out when you get time. And so it is obvious that to call a man a cardinal in the hierarchy of Rome is to also declare that man to be vice pope. And since there are literally millions of quotes in all sorts of publications confirming this effect that cardinals are second only to the pope, I'm going to quote from just one of these publications that the Vatican actually uses to teach its flock all about their hierarchy. That book is something every Catholic is familiar with. It's their catechism. And this is what it says about cardinals. It says the college or body of bishops or cardinals has no authority unless united with the Roman pontiff, Peter's successor, as its head. As such, this college has supreme and full authority over the universal church, but this power cannot be exercised without the agreement of the Roman pontiff, or pope, for those of you that aren't Roman Catholic. And so even the description of the office of cardinal is clearly the same as the office of vice president when used in the ecclesiastical sense. And so with that said, does the Seventh-day Adventist Church also embrace the office of the cardinal, since we already know they have embraced its pagan hierarchy structure, as I shared in a previous video, wherein they place the Seventh-day Adventist president above Jesus in the church in the exact same way the pope stands in the Roman church. And since we already know the SDA leadership has declared in writing that they already see some of their women workers in the same exact way as the pope does when it comes to his nuns, as I shared in another video. So could it be they also have the same Roman Catholic office of the cardinal in the SDA church? Well, we already know there are more than a few vice presidents in the General Conference divisions, and so does the leadership of the SDA church go so far as to describe them as Roman Catholic cardinals? Notice what a past president of the General Conference, Neil C. Wilson, who is the father of the current Seventh-day Adventist president, notice what he stated back in 1985. It says, division and general conference officers form a critical area of church leadership around the world. Vice presidents, and you understand that division presidents are first vice presidents of the general conference, report to the general conference president according to the bylaws. While they serve a division, they are vice presidents of the general conference. If you compare vice presidents to cardinals, we already have a cardinal from Africa. And before this session ends, and he's talking about the 1985 General Conference, he says that, I predict we will have two African cardinals among our 15 vice presidents. There is no cardinal from all the countries of the Far East, while there will probably be two cardinals from Africa. And think about what he just said here in regards to all division presidents who are vice presidents of the General Conference president. Since he just described these vice presidents in a way that likens them onto the same office of the Roman Catholic cardinal that makes the General Conference president the one supreme leader or pope of the entire Seventh-day Adventist Church in the same way as the pope is declared supreme leader of the Vatican and the Roman Catholic Church. And since we know the Seventh-day Adventist General Conference and even the vice presidents of same never demanded Neil C. Wilson recant his statement about cardinals in the SDA Church. And the fact the SDA Church already has a Vatican in Maryland, wherein the pagan hierarchy is confirmed now in reality, this means the Seventh-day Adventist people, who for the most part are totally unaware of all this, these poor souls trapped in apostasy officially have a pope named Ted Wilson as we speak, who is the son of Neil C. Wilson that declared his office to be the same as that of the Roman Pope long before his son took on that very same office. Thank you for watching. God bless.